second knockdown. Eddie Cochran's gonna start the count.
Seven! Come on, second round, show me. Eight! You gotta show me something. You gotta show me something.
Mitchell has rubbery legs. I don't think Banks finish him right here.
You heard Cochran say you gotta show me something. Somewhere Emanuel Steward is cheering as Banks tries to get it done. Third knockdown on the round. And that's it. The fight is over. Seven. Mitchell has been knocked out by Jonathan Banks. An amazing upset. Steward magic.
The fighter who started at 15 beat the fighter who started at 25. What role did Emanuel Steward's passing play into this fight tonight?
Well, the role of Emanuel Steward played into my life, and fighting is my life. So I just want to dedicate this to him, because I know he's a man of knockouts. He loves knockouts. So I dedicate this to Emanuel Steward. Never forgotten, and we're truly going to miss him.
What feelings are running through your head?
You know, all is running through my head. I got so much momentum going right now. All I'm thinking about is how thankful I am for Emanuel Steward. That's all that's running through my head right now. I'm thankful for Emanuel Steward, because without him, he taught me the game of boxing. Without boxing, I wouldn't be here right now.
When I think of amateur boxing, I think of the beginning little boy, call little girl nowadays, that goes to a gym and is just jumping around, wanting to learn how to throw a punch, maybe to try to win a little trophy, to do something that maybe they, especially for little kids who are physically small and would not be able to necessarily grow and compete in basketball and football and the other sports that require someone to be big. You see so many of the poor kids that are there, they are training. That recreation center is their center of the universe for some of them. The situation at home is pretty bad sometimes for different reasons. Maybe it's financial, maybe it's even violence. And so those kids come there and they're beating those bags and looking at a way of maybe getting out of poverty. Many of the kids are, will ask me for 50 cents. Can I get 50 cents? You know, and the 50 cents is to actually buy potato chips or something, because that is the only food that they'll have. And so one day I may be doing an HBO broadcast, living in the big hotels in New York, and Las Vegas, big suites, limousines picking me up, and being involved with so many multi-million dollar situations and people. And then when I get back to the gym the next day and take off those tuxedos, it keeps me connected with reality, that everybody isn't living the big life. And then I go right down to that little basement down in Crump, and that's where I'm the happiest, because I see all the little kids, a lot of the people who are older in life who have fell through the cracks, so to say, of our life, and they're less fortunate, and they're there, and it's just happy this evening. I go in and we talk and we hug, and we start getting ready for one of the amateur tournaments. And I love being in the tournaments when you see one kid fight, and then the next night, you know, he's going to be fighting.
is even more than you can dream of. Just imagine if you bought a ticket. Stop it, Frank. You can stop it anytime.